back. This is John with Mechanical Pros, and today got my man Quentin here with us, and we're going to be talking about Daikin VRV IV inverter boards, doing a little diode bridge test. Quentin, good to see you.
Glad to be here.
Yeah, tell me what we got going on here.
Yeah, so what we've done here is we've taken an inverter board out of a Daikin VRV IV. Naturally, this will normally be inside of the VRV module. Earlier, in one of the earlier videos, we talked about the heat sink on the back of the inverter board, which is cooled by the refrigerant circuit that we saw. But basically, what we're going to talk about today is how to test out the diode bridge on this inverter board. We put it here on the bench for simplicity's sake, but let's get into it. So the first thing that you're going to want to have is a good meter that has the capability of reading diodes. So the first thing you're going to want to do, turn it on.
What are you using here?
This is a Fluke 179.
Okay.
So this is a new meter for me. It's a little bit fancier than what I'm used to. I'm used to the cheap meters, but this one's nice. So we're going to go ahead and change it over to the diode setting. And the first thing that we're going to want to do is identify these three little four or five little solder points here. We've got a positive terminal, we have a negative terminal, and then we have three other terminals in the center there. So the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to take our red meter lead and place it on the positive terminal. And then we're going to take our black meter lead and stick it on the first of the three center terminals. You'll notice that we have OL. We're going to go to the second terminal. We have OL again. And then last, we're going to go to that third terminal, OL once again. We're going to take our red meter lead now and put it on the negative terminal. We're going to take our black meter lead and start the process all over. But this time, you're going to notice we have 0.487 volts DC. Time to go to the second terminal. Same thing. And then our last terminal, we have that same value again. So now, we're going to move over and start using our black terminal.
So what are you looking for?
So we're looking for consistency, right?
Yeah.
We want to see 0.48 to 0.5. Volts DC on each one of those terminals.
Okay.
But you have to do it in this sequence. Otherwise, it's kind of meaningless. So it's important to also note that you have your meter leads in the correct orientation to remove any confusion.
And so what are you trying to eliminate by doing this sequence?
So you want to make sure that your diode bridge is functional, that it's not blown apart.
Okay.
A lot of times you'll see physical damage, but that's not always the case. So now we're going to take our black meter lead. We're going to go to the positive terminal. Red meter lead to the first terminal. We have 0.48, looks good. Gonna go to the next terminal, 0.48, and our last terminal, 0.48. So now we're gonna swap our terminals around again. We're gonna use our black meter lead on negative, red meter lead on terminal one, we have OL. Red meter lead on point two, OL. Then red meter lead on our third terminal, we have OL again. So by judging this test here, the diode bridge on this particular inverter board is in good shape. We took this out of a functional unit just for video's sake, but that's exactly what we're looking for. This is a good functional inverter board. There's an additional test that we're going to do in future videos on how to conduct the inverter transistor check while this board is still in the module, but you'll have to keep an eye out for that one.
Okay. So I know the diode bridge is functional. So what is that diode bridge actually doing? What is it?
So basically,
what's its function in the machine?
Yeah, so the way that I like to explain a diode bridge is kind of like a check valve is to water. This is kind of like a check valve for electricity. So it only allows the electricity to flow in one direction. And so whenever we have all these switching circuits taking place, we want to make sure that the electricity is always going down the correct paths.
Okay. And it's switching back and forth due to the inverter compressor?
Yes. Yes, that's correct.
Okay. All right, cool. Well, thanks. Hit that like, hit that subscribe, and we'll bring you some more cool HVAC videos coming at you.